I'll add something funny.
Yeah, go for it, bro.
Okay, it stays in.
I saw your sweats move.
Yeah, dude, there was
just
a nice.
Look at Adidas ripple. It's blue.
There was a nice little ripple. I've been getting into farting. I've been getting into beating off more. I've had a really wild class.
Corona beating off is a different animal.
I've been putting up wild numbers. I don't know. I took Adderall. Sometimes I feel like I beat off more on Adderall.
Yeah, because your dick doesn't get fully hard.
See, I don't. Okay, here, about this. Doesn't. If you take Adderall and a dick pill,
yeah,
then it's the limit. Then it's limitless.
Is this like limitless? Like,
yeah. Then I'm Bradley Cooper.
Just imagine, because
it's awesome, dude. It rocks.
It'd be great if he masturbated all throughout the movie. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
Is it, when you're at higher altitudes, easier or harder to maintain an erection?
Oh, interesting.
I would think it'd be harder, right? Because you do need.
Blood is thinner.
Yeah.
Well, less oxygen,
but it's more viscous.
That's true.
Harder to concentrate.
Right? So underwater, would your dick get even thicker? Because water is because you're.
Sav, you know what you should do this winter? You should go to Denver and train.
beat off at the peak.
Rocky and Rocky Four. Drago. You got a piece of wood.
You should get an Airbnb in Denver, and I can smash up all the dishes.
I'd be like a Kenyan marathon runner.
Yeah. But it's about getting pussy.
But it's about getting pussy. You still bust in 3 minutes, so it doesn't really matter.
No, I don't bust fast. You know I have a fucked up foreskin that stops me from busting fast.
Mm-hmm.
It's a gift and a curse at the same time. I honestly can count on that one hand the amount of times I've really busted super fast.
Yeah, you got stamina. Like,
but it's because my dick is fucked up.
I don't see, sitting here across from you, because I'm telling you, people were messaging me all day, like, knowing that I might be doing this. The amount of questions. One girl asked me, please look at his crotch and let me know.
I'll say this.
What, he's hard?
Not hard.
He's coming in his pants?
He's hard right now.
If everyone wants to know, my dick is not as small as I say, but it's not big. How about that?
It's powerful to say your dick is very small.
It's powerful.
Your dick is powerful.
I don't have like a sub.
I do the same thing.
Yeah.
I feel like it's famous. I think it's like more famous than you. Like your dick got JFL. You know what I mean?
Yeah. My dick has done more than I have. But it's fine. Honestly, I have to say, there's certain angles. I've taken some pics of my penis where I'm like, who is this guy? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Where I'm like, hell yeah, dude. Mm-hmm. I send that one.
But you should do that thing that some artists or conceptual artists do. They take a photo every day for a year and they just make this huge exhibition.
I should. Because some days my dick looks awesome, dude.
You should take a picture before and after you tell your dick it's beautiful.
Talk to it like a plant. Talk to it like a plant.
Dove real cock.
We should do that, dude. You're the beautiful. Dove real cock.
It would be funny if men did dumb shit like that also.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They would just have like, we all hang out and show each other our cocks and draw them.
Ass dicks. Yeah, soft.
We all draw each other's cocks.
Oh my God, I would kill to have that kind of cock.
It was like a spiritual experience for us. We all grew closer together, even though we all hate each other and gossip about each other constantly.
We'll never
we fuck the same person, and now we'll never forgive each other. But that's what brotherhood is about. That's why we had to create an Instagram account so everyone knows that we're friends.
Women are constantly just trying to destroy each other.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're just at war with each other, 100%.
I know. Well, that's why they can't be in charge of the world. The best example
is like girls move in, they become roommates, and then they get like notes all over the house. So it's like, I love us, house rules, best friends forever.
Yeah.
And like two guys can live with each other for a decade and be like, I think that guy's name is Glenn. But if the house phone rang and it's like, hey man, it's Glenn, your roommate, can you bail me out of jail? You'd be like, oh yeah, I guess I gotta go bail out my roommate.
Yeah.
That's why.
Whereas a girl would be like, sorry, yeah. Beth. No, I forgot. You used my stand mixer to impress that guy I liked. So now we hate each other.
Yeah.
It does feel like a lot of those friendships are made only to destroy that person in private. Because I've seen, like, let's just say I've had a history of like dating lady comics.
Mm.
And you'll
the
see
worst the people in the entire world. Yeah.
Lesbians.
They should be in unequivocally, they should be gas.
That should be a genocide.
There should be a van that comes by that says 5 minutes of stage time in here.
It's a truck that says Refinery 29. Yes.
Yeah. Refinery 29 half hour series. You're a finalist. Hop in.
The exhaust pumps right back into the fucking cargo.
If Trump did a tweet and he was like, all the lady comics, they're monsters. Mm-hmm. We're sending them. We're ejecting them from this country. Mm-hmm. I would for a half a second be
You'd vote for him?
I might, maybe.
Yeah. You should, man.
But it'll be historic, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's how he unites the tent. That's the key to the big tent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is throw all the lady comics onto the bus. But anyway, you were saying?
No, but just watching the glimmer they have in their eye. To talk about, I've seen
when someone's when someone fucks something up, the look they have to like punish them for it.
Yeah. Especially if you're not somebody that's known for talking shit. And I'm not saying all. This is the one I've been around.
Of course.
It's like if you're not known for talking, but you can say nasty shit. First of all, goes to appearance, who they fucked. Mm-hmm. Well, I remember this one woman I was with. She was talking about somebody who's famous, who's a public figure. And guess what's going on all night about how she smelled?
Oh, yeah.
You know, because she had a fat person smell.
Yeah.
Was this the girl from the Ari special with the one arm?
Wait, what?
Remember the Ari Shaffir had a special a couple years ago where
he was trashing some lady with one arm who wasn't even famous.
That worked at or she didn't work at it. She was just hanging out at the comedy store. But in his special, he's like, she just had that, you know, that like fat smell. And it was so funny because that clip, it was before they finally got him with Kobe. It took forever for the world to get Ari because Ari would just do this horrific shit and then just be like, yeah, you just turn off your phone.
He's like,
all you have to do is not look at your phone.
For like 2 weeks, you just get off the internet.
Yeah, go on a vacation.
Yeah.
It's free. You don't have to work. You just got time off work.
Yeah.
I feel bad for him because I talked to black comics in LA who, like, he doesn't know when he touches down and the comedy store opens up, that fade is waiting for him. Yeah. Like,
did you see the video Godfrey made? Did you see the video Godfrey made?
Yeah.
He's like, Ari fucks around. He's a comedian, but this time he went too far. And he goes, I mean, he's like basically like, if he gets killed because of this, he will have deserved it. It's fucking wild. Godfrey was like, the most chill, not going to rock the boat with, like, anything. Yeah. Yeah. Just fucking, he's like, if Ari gets killed, he had it coming.
I used to open for him in the Bay Area, and knowing that, like, if Godfrey came in and just wanted to fight Ari Shaffir, like, Ari would have to just murder him on site. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The amount of working out and all the natural medicine, he's basically our Luke Cage. You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God. He's incredible.
He could end SARS. Like, I think like, if they flew him back there, he could just kill all the cops out there, unrape all the people, you know what I mean? And just take it to. But Ari's about to, dude, I would just stay away from LA. he's just got to start doing like that movie Green Room. Mm-hmm. He can start doing shows in the forest, you know what I mean?
For Nazis?
Yeah.
Star Trek Nazis? Yes, we're actually white supremacists. That's such a funny casting.
Yeah, that's
the Nazis would just have like some
Picard.
Like, yes, just like this, a fat British man.
Yeah,
it's like, would you like to join my racist gang in the forest?
We're going to rape the Chinese. That movie rocked.
Yeah, we met the guy from Star Wars, and he's doing Nazi shit out in the woods.
Damn.
The guy's phone finally works in the woods, and he's like, we met at Picard.
There was a line in that Dead Bang movie I watched. The premise is like Don Johnson. He's just some alcoholic cop whose wife left him, and then a cop gets murdered in L.A., and then he's like investigating the murder. It turns out to be connected to this like white supremacist ring.
Oh, nice.
It's like nationwide, so he's like blowing up this like huge case of connected white supremacy, but he's going through the evidence from like the initial bus, and there's all this like hate speech shit, and he's reading it, and he's like, you know, it's like we have to secure a future for the white race, and he's like, so what, they just sit around writing this bullshit all day? Like, Don Johnson rocks.
Oh, he's incredible.
Yeah, he's so fucking
incredible.
Yeah.
No, that was, I was like, I was surprised that that movie was as entertaining as it was.
I might watch that. I love Don Johnson.
It was Don Johnson's the best. I saw him in San Francisco. He was filming Nash Bridges.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
That guy is truly Johnny on the spot.
Yeah.
Like he, I was enamored because I was sitting down there and I was with some young, and a lady asked for a cigarette, like a light, and he gets, before she even finished the sentence, gets had the lighter ready to go.
Yeah. Another guy that's charismatic to a degree that people don't even appreciate because he kind of transcends that like disgusting 80s malaise where like you watch Miami Vice now and he doesn't seem like a fucking 80s dork.
Right.
Whereas
the
other guy, what's his name?
Yeah.
Tubbs?
Yeah, but the actor's name.
Oh,
I don't know his name.
Wait a minute.
Jamie Foxx.
Yeah.
Wait.
Harry Belafonte.
No. It's
I'm picturing his face right now.
Yeah, because he's got his last name sounds like how wavy his hair is.
Yeah, he had a curly do.
He's one of the only people that has a Tony, an Oscar, an Emmy. And
he's an EGOT.
Yeah.
No, he does not.
Yeah, he does.
He has an Oscar.
He does. Yeah.
For what?
I don't know. I just said that. no, actually, what I think it is he has a necklace that says.
Tommy, is it like?
He has a necklace that says EGOT because he wanted to go into music after Miami Vice. Michael Philip Thomas. Or Philip Michael Thomas.
Philip Michael Thomas.
And yeah, he wanted to go into he looks crazy now.
Did he lose his hair?
No, he grew like a big gray beard out.
Oh, he looks cool now.
He looks like Santa.
Oh, shit. Like, he does look kind of cool.
Like Black Letterman?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a handsome guy.
Yeah, career, Miami Vice, Nash Bridges, Grand Theft Auto, Vice City. What a funny arc. Mm-hmm. video games, Sneaker Commercial.
The famous show I was on, my co-star's second show that he pity gave me a spot on, and then a video game based off of the show I was on.
You keep scrolling down, it says Psychic Readers Network.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah.
I hope he's fucking caked up. I hope he's not broke.
Yeah.
He's too cute.
Whoa, yeah, we are in the place to be.